In this video, I'm going to show you how to do face swaps in Photoshop. I'm going to start this tutorial by showing you how to cut out the woman's face and match it to the man's body. Then I'm going to show you how to color correct the face so that it matches the skin tones of the body. And finally, I'll show you how to make the merge by using the Auto Blends Layers feature in Photoshop. We're going to be working with these two images, this woman's face and this man's body. And what we want to do is we want to take her face and place it on his head. Before we get started, I want to point out that this works best when both faces are facing a similar direction and have a similar head tilt. So that means that if you have opposing perspectives and angles, then this is not going to work as well. It's going to look a little fake. So try to get the angles of the head and face matching as best as possible. So the first thing that we're going to do is select the lasso tool to make a selection around her face. You can select the lasso tool by pressing L on the keyboard or by selecting it from the tools bar. Notice that every tool has the keyboard shortcut to the right of it. In this case, it's L. Then you can make a selection around the face. So that's what I'm going to do now. If you made a mistake, you can hold Alt and Option on the Mac to subtract from a selection, or hold Shift to add to a selection. So I'm holding Shift and clicking and dragging and adding to the selection. So that's what you want to select more or less. Then you can press Control J, Command J on the Mac to duplicate that layer. And now we just have a face. So I'm going to call this layer Face. Then I can press V on the keyboard to select the Move tool, click and drag on the face, and drag it over onto the Other Documents tab. I'm still holding, and I'm going to release, and it'll release the layer there. Now the layer's in this document. It's a good idea to always work with a face that is larger than the face you're trying to swap out. That way you have the advantage of distorting and scaling pixels and not have any pixelation. So what I'm going to do now is match the size of both faces. So I'm going to press Ctrl-T, Command-T to transform. And I'm going to click and drag on the opacity label, click and drag to the left to bring down the opacity, and then move this over his face. I'm going to use the eyes to match the face. So I'm going to press Control plus, Command plus on the Mac to zoom in, and I'm going to try to align the corner of the eyes here. And that's where I want to scale from. So notice right now that if I click on one of these corner handles and scale, I'm not going to scale from that spot. So what I want to do is hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and click to move the pivot point. Notice how the pivot point was down here. You could also click and drag it, of course, but it's easier to hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and click. There's the pivot point. Now if I scale by holding Shift, Alt, Shift, Option, it scales from that point. And of course, it rotates from that point as well. So I'm going to try to match the eyes as best as I can. And notice how these two are not lining up. Well, we can rotate it just a little bit and adjust it as best as we can. I'm going to bring the opacity back up to 100%. I'm going to press Enter, and I think that looks pretty good. I'm going to zoom out and we'll see what that looks like. And I think this will work. I think I might just rotate it to the left just a little more. So I'm going to bring back the pivot point there and just do a slight rotation. Not too much, maybe something like that. And I think this will look better. Now, when you're doing face swaps, it's always a good idea for both faces to have similar skin tones, similar colors, similar color cast, and things like that. So when you merge the layers together, they look much better. So I'm going to show you how to match her skin tone to his skin tone really easily and really quickly. So I have the face selected. Then I'm going to go into Image, Adjustments, Match Color. And from here, we can select the source. That is the document that we're working in. We're working in the muscularman.jpg document. So select that. And then the layer where you want to take colors from. We want to take colors from the background layer. So select the background. Now that doesn't look very good. And that's because the background has the gray and other colors that we really don't need. We only want the colors of the face. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cancel that, hold Control, Command, and click on the face layer thumbnail to make a selection around the face, and then I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to go into Image, Adjustment, Match Color, Source, muscular man, layer, background. And notice the difference. Now we're only looking at the colors that are on the face, which is what we want. It's a little strong, so I'm going to fade it a little bit. And notice how that matches the colors even better. I'm going to press OK. Then I'm going to press Control D, Command D to deselect. And I'm going to zoom in. And now we can keep working on this image. The problem now is that the original background image does not have a lot of skin texture. In fact, it's a bit blurry. So we're going to have to match that. So I'm going to go into Filter and Blur. But before I do that, I want to make sure that I don't create any soft edges around the image here. So I'm going to lock the transparent pixels. Then go into Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. And I can move the slider around to add blur. But for something like this, it's better to start all the way to the left and use the up arrow keys on the keyboard to add blur, or the down arrow key on the keyboard to take away blur. So I think about 0.3 will be good for this example. Then I'm going to press OK. And if you want to add more blur in certain areas, then you can use the blur tool. And there it is. I'm taking away some of the skin texture here on the cheeks just because it's not like that on the original image and we want it to match as best as possible. When you're done, you can just unlock the transparent pixels, and I think the image is looking much better now. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna duplicate the background layer. Control J, Command J on the Mac, and I'm gonna disable the original background. I'm gonna call the copy body. So we have the face and we have the body. I'm gonna press Control, Command, and click on the layer thumbnail to make a selection around the face. Select the body, and I'm gonna go into Select, Modify, Contract, and I'm going to select 5 pixels. For your image, you may need more or less pixels depending on the size of your image. So if 5 pixels doesn't work for you, try adding 10, try adding 20, or maybe just add a couple. So I'm going to press OK, and notice how I have that space in between the selection and the edge of the face layer. That's what you want. So I'm going to disable the face layer. And with the body layer selected, I'm gonna press the delete key or backspace on the keyboard to remove those pixels. You could also use the eraser tool, of course, or any other tool that deletes pixels. And now we have the body. If for whatever reason you hit the delete key and the face is still showing, it's probably because you have the two layers enabled. So make sure that you disable the background layer and only the body layer is enabled so that you see through it. So I can put the face on top of that and bring the opacity all the way to 100% just to make sure that we don't see any of the transparency. Then I can press Control D, Command D to deselect. And I'm going to zoom out just so you can see what's going to happen here. So I'm going to zoom out just a little bit. I'm going to select the face. I'm going to hold Shift, click on the body. I've selected both. And I'm going to go into Edit, Auto Blend Layers. And make sure you have panorama selected, seamless tones and colors, content aware fill transparent areas, and press OK. And notice the magic. Photoshop blends those two layers automatically and it looks great. And one other thing, sometimes you may get an outline around the face. If you see this result, you can try increasing the contraction something more than 5 pixels. Or if it's any easier for you, you can create a new layer and use the Helium Brush tool with content aware to get rid of the outline.